It is nearly a week since we left the mooring in Tarmouth, and I am glad to have gone. It is an ugly, violent town. Every day the few thousand residents are joined by huge numbers who come from the city at dawn, making their way from Eucrobus on my home and the place that wants me dead. They think I'm responsible for the catastrophe that nearly tore Eucrobus on apart. I had no choice but to board the Terpsichorea, the next ship heading straight for the colony. I had no choice but to resort to self-exile. We have stopped at Dancing Bird Island for a night. It is tawdry, a place for tourists. I don't feel any great need for greasy food or trinkets. These islands depress me. We were attacked by pirates. We lost the fight. The pirate leader told us to surrender, which we did quickly and unanimously. He told us the fighting was over, seconds after killing our captain. He told us we would be forced to go with him to a new city. Where are we going? Locked in our cabins and questioned, as if these pirates were census takers. Name, they ask, and occupation. They let me keep some of my things. This notebook they let me keep, and my letters, pictures, and clothes. The rest they take away. For loot, maybe. We are here. The city is called Armada. It is made of hundreds of ships, airships, and other sea vessels, all connected, ruled by a man and woman with mirroring scars. They are called the Lovers. They tell the prisoners and the slaves that here they are all sailors and citizens, that here they are all equal. Of course. The prisoner scum eat it right up. They cheer. I'm not so easily won, but what can I do? They offered me a job in the library. They gave me a room in a paddle ship called the Cromolith. They won't ever let me leave.